1970s that the Soviet Union looked to counter potential Western opponents like the F-15 Eagle and the United States Air Force.
Speeds of between 350 and 450 knots. When you bear in mind it has a max takeoff weight of 72,000 pounds and with a wingspan of 15 metres, when compared against something like, say, the F-16 of 42,000 pounds or 10 metres wingspan, this is 50% bigger than those other fast jets we've seen earlier today. And the Mulca Romeo Saturn,
Yes.
Very impressive for a number of reasons. Firstly, aerodynamically, bear in mind the strength of the aircraft is built in laterally, but for the aircraft to be going forward. So in a tail slide, the stresses and strains on the aircraft are amplified. Also, the flight control inputs are in the opposite sense to make the aircraft do what it can do whilst going forward. But also the engines, they require hundreds of litres of air per second, and with the air going in the direction. So we've seen it once, and now we're going to see it again. Does make you wonder, the first time this manoeuvre was ever done, was it deliberate?
Still,
67 Su-27s were taken on by the Ukrainian Air Force when the country became independent from the Soviet Union, and they carried on serving in the same roles as they had back in Soviet times. Apart from the flankers like this one, they... squadron stationed at Otserna in the north of Ukraine. The standard armament much the same as it was in the Soviet era. Medium range R-27 and short range R-73 air-to-air missiles, maximum of 10 in all. Plus the aircraft has an internal 30mm cannon, and they say they practice close air support with these aircraft, so presumably because of the lack of air-to-ground stores, they would use the cannon for that. Now, we can tell this is an upgraded flanker because of the so-called pixelated colour scheme that's applied in blue, and that is put on the aeroplanes after they undergo a general overhaul. The same is true of other Ukrainian Air Force aircraft. And now, a slow pass with the big dorsal air brake extended. cost of upgrading these aeroplanes is, apart from giving them a new satellite navigation and systems. Transponders to allow them to participate in international operations under various internationally recognised regulations to preparation for commentating on all of these aircraft. And some of it for the flanker related to the sort of flying that they practice on a daily basis back in Ukraine. Of course, they do one versus one, two versus two, aerial combat, and then it said melee. I like the sound of that. And there's that big air brake extended once again as the aircraft comes into land. The Ukrainian Air Force Sukhoi Su-27P1M. There's some aerodynamic braking going on as well, holding the nose wheel off, and we're just about to see.